Hello everybody, this is Bitcoin Macro, and on this video guys I'm gonna talk about Bitcoin and Bitcoin only. I'm gonna do a proper technical analysis and mention several things that I like and I don't like for Bitcoin at the moment, what you should be looking at and so on. But before I get into all that stuff guys, please remember to like, share and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get more notifications, and of course remember to follow me on Twitter, Telegram and TradingView, because I have been sharing tons of important stuff over there, lots of updates, lots of little ideas. So right now I'm just gonna sum everything up that I have been sharing and just tell you guys what I think at the moment. So let's get straight into it, and the first thing that I would talk about guys is the fact that the Bitcoin price has found support at the 350-day moving average. So the 350 has been very important support, and I mentioned that on the previous video that I did about Bitcoin. And every single time that Bitcoin had touched the 350-day moving average in a bull market, the bull market was over. So it was actually only touching the 350-day moving average in a bear market, but obviously it wasn't very clear whether it was a bull, a bear, or whatever until that moving average was clearly broken. And every time it had touched it, it had initially had a pretty significant bounce. So every touch on the 350-day moving average had the bounce, and the bounces were 63%, 55%, 95%, and 63%. So three different bounces after a big run-up, of course. I'm not talking about when Bitcoin is going sideways. Those don't count. I'm talking about being touched after a big rally, a big drop, and then having a significant bounce. So Bitcoin is currently bouncing pretty nicely, and it has been breaking some very important levels, which I'm going to talk about in a different chart, because right now I just want to focus on the moving averages only and what I think about them. So we're having the 50-day moving average coming down, and that's pretty significant in my opinion, because clearly the momentum has been down, although we might be seeing a shift. Now, it might find some resistance here on the 50-day moving average, but I think it will probably eventually break. I don't really believe this moving average will just hold the price down forever, except if we just touch it and we get rejected straight away. Now, the 300-day moving average has been touched so many times that it actually broke twice, but every time that we reclaim it, I'm a little bit more bullish. Now, every time we lose it, I'm a little bit more bearish, because it's very clear to me that this is a very important moving average. It held a support essentially almost three times during this drop, and then it actually started chopping, and that's the good thing. Like, breaking it and then reclaiming it is pretty healthy, at least for the bull case. Now, if we lose it again, I would say that if we lose a 350-day moving average, then that's when I think it's going to be over. So essentially, when we lose 30K, or for more certainty, 29K, it's probably going to be over for the bull case. I don't know what's going to happen in the meantime, because my opinion is that maybe the price can get up to 44K, which is about the 200-day moving average, or a little higher to 47K, because if we just assume that the price is going to bounce at about 65%, like it usually does after touching the 350-day moving average, it might have a really significant rally, which might be a bull trap. We don't know if it's going to be a bull trap or if it's going to be a resumption of the bull market, but for now we should assume that this is going to be just a bull trap, just a dead cat bounce, or just a pretty significant rally. Now, of course, many of you have heard of me mention this before, that this might be accumulation, and many of you have already seen different charts of Wyckoff, like the Wyckoff method, Wyckoff schematic, depends on how you want to call it, doesn't matter. But the key thing is that we have been in some sort of accumulation range. I don't think that this looks like distribution, although it could be. And you know, sometimes people really think that although this might be accumulation, they kind of don't see the fact that maybe it is accumulation. People might have been accumulating and they might plan to dump not much higher, okay? So the key levels are all here. So first one is the 37K level, which has been resistance before. It has been support. It is an important level. Plus, it has a really important volume profile point right here, like a high volume node. So if this gets a big rejection, maybe we do get down to 33K, which I think would be healthy because we have the weekly pivot, we have an interesting gap right there on this chart, the spot chart, and on CME have one a little lower, but I don't think that's very significant for us to really go back down there. Although it might, I would assume that going back down there might be a little tricky because this accumulation has to come at an end pretty soon, and it should slowly just chop in these areas. The price should stay above 33K, maybe chop a little bit between 35 and 38K, and then slowly go higher. Now the next resistance level is at 40K, right above the 38-37K resistance. The next one is at 40, but it's not going to be that strong. So I would assume that potentially if we get something like this, oops, excuse me, just give me 1 second. There's something wrong with the arrows. Yeah, that's fine. So if we get something like this, guys, I wouldn't be surprised because I think this would look pretty healthy. And then we go slowly higher. So the slower we go up, the more the bull case can hold true, because the slower we go up, the more the accumulation continues, the healthier the market looks, so we might have the chance to go much, much higher. So for now, the truth is that we are in a bullish trend, at least based on the low time frames. On the high time frames, we're still in a bear market, or at least in a downtrend, I should say. But of course, we have been in this range, so at least in the short term, we do treat this like a range, like a potential accumulation or distribution area. And for now, what we have seen, guys, is we had this very important low after the big drop. Now, on different exchanges, it fell on different prices, like some of them were 28K, some of them were 30K, some of them 29K. So it was an anomalous drop. And what I have told you before is that usually the price does go back down to those areas of like the anomalous drop. And it actually did come and sweep those lows. Now, before, on May 19th, on some exchanges, we had seen those lows get swept, the ones on the end of January at about 29K. And the real final sweep was on the 22nd. So all markets were in agreement, essentially. Okay, and that's a good sign because we had those lows, every single low had been broken. And then that was a very nice trap for shorters. So late shorts got trapped, got squeezed. And that's why, in my opinion, we had a very nice bottoming pattern over here, because next time we came down to this level at 30K, this turned back into resistance. This is one of my favorite patterns as well. When you have just a line where the market comes down, then the market goes up a little bit, then it comes just a little bit. That doesn't really matter how much it dips, it just doesn't have to be way too much. So just a little dip lower, and then when the market at some point comes down to the initial low and find support and goes higher, that's pretty good. That's a strong bullish signal for me, and that's why I've liked it. Like I've mentioned that on Twitter, I've mentioned that on Telegram, but I didn't have the chance to make a video recently. So right now what we are seeing is that we have had enough accumulation based on the volume profile. This looks like a pretty nice distribution. We have had people buying, we have seen quite a bit of strength, and all we don't want to see is that area to break down, because again, if we break below 29K, it won't be nice. It won't be nice, at least that's my opinion. I don't really believe it would be able to hold again, because it would just confirm that this is a very big downtrend. Now, if we just have a look, on the Binance perps, what you can see over here is that we actually have a quadruple bottom of, like, depends on how you want to call it. Maybe you want to call it a triple bottom, a double bottom, doesn't really matter, because yes, we did sweep the lows over here, but on the 22nd of June, we didn't really sweep the low of the 19th of May. So we do have a little double bottom over here, and although we are coming above the middle of the range, there is still resistance in that area. It won't be easy. Like, the path of going higher is probably going to have more resistance than the path of going lower. At least if we start testing 29K again, maybe we do have a little bounce all the way up to 32K, but after that I do believe it's going to be the end and we're going to go much lower. Now, In my opinion, at least for the bearish scenario, which I've mentioned before, I do believe that, you know, 24K is a very important level, 20K is going to be a very important level, and potentially maybe the price just does go all the way down to about 18K, 17K, and then we will bottom around there. Because again, Bitcoin is cheap, along like many models are pointing to that. They have been saying that Bitcoin is very, very cheap, actually, based on, you know, stable coins in the market, based on stock to flow model, based on NVT. So a lot of these models have been saying Bitcoin is very cheap. But of course, like I said before, maybe Bitcoin does get a lot cheaper before it starts going higher again. Because again, the market might be on a panic mode. Who knows? Maybe it's because of the miners getting out of China. Maybe something goes wrong. Maybe some laws, whatever. Because again, although the low we had on the 22nd of June at 28,700 was also part of the China crackdown. There was a little bit of an extra panic, and the previous pump from 31K was because of El Salvador and the MicroStrategy buying. But overall, I would have to say that Bitcoin is working fine so far. I am a little worried until, you know, the whole China situation resolves and we do see hash rate come back. But so far, the capitulation of hash rate is good because less coins are being produced. We are not seeing miners really sell at the moment. So we do have a bit of a restricted supply. Less money is coming onto the market. Less Bitcoin, is being sold. So that's pretty healthy in my opinion. And it does help the market go up. Now, of course, I don't know how things are gonna go and play out, because I'm surprised China hasn't cracked down on Bitcoin more badly to attack it or anything like it. But it's pretty good and pretty healthy that more and more miners are getting out of China and into other countries. I think that's very good and very healthy for the ecosystem to get more distributed and to just get into other countries as well. Again, in my opinion, at least for now, this low at 29K has to hold. And for now that we are getting about the middle of the range, I do expect a little bit more chop. But I do expect chop, but the market will potentially go slowly higher. Now, the other thing that I wanted to mention over here is the fact that we do have all these resistance levels. And I don't really know where Bitcoin could actually stop, but the best place would potentially be 44K, because we do have that old support over there at about 44 and 43K, which is also coinciding with the 200-day moving average, or it's gonna go a little higher. Now, if the market keeps breaking higher, which I don't really expect to happen in one go, if Bitcoin starts going higher, it's going to take some time. It's probably going to take maybe a month or two. So we're going to get a bit of extra chop in this area. Maybe I should say just a month until we really, really break above 47K. We would need potentially a month, maybe 2 months to break that area to and really start a new bull market. But the other main one is about 53 and 54K, which in my opinion is probably the best area for the market to have a local top. But after that top, I don't think the market is going to go much lower. I do believe it could potentially have a dip, but then it would potentially continue much higher. I don't really expect a bull trap all the way to 53K. The best bull trap would be around 44K. The next best one, which I would accept as a bull trap, would be 47K, but I would be a little bit more neutral to bullish at that point. But for now, I do believe Bitcoin can go higher, because again, the Wyckoff schematic could be right. Bitcoin is cheap along many, many different indicators. So far, I don't really think that there is a big problem with these soft bottoms over here, because the accumulation could really hold true. Although I'm not a fan of Bitcoin testing the 28K to 31K area so many times, because it makes me think that it will eventually break. But as long as we don't go below 30K again, I think we are safe, and this could be accumulation. So although these levels are kind of rare to have, like, you know, these big gaps below and these like kind of crazy rallies without Bitcoin turning down. But I do believe that because we are in a different era for Bitcoin of, you know, long-term adoption and people coming in, it might just be really different this time around. And the only thing that I would mention for altcoins at the moment, guys, is that alts go really, really cheap, like falling 60, 70, 80, 90%. And we have seen some really, really large wipeouts, at least in USD terms. Now, in Bitcoin terms, they are still looking a little frothy, but we have to remember that they came out of a really, really massive low and their fundamentals have been improving for quite some time. So it has been a pretty strange situation because alts versus Bitcoin had a massive capitulation, because at least alts in 2016, 2015, and 2017, they were in a constant uptrend. At least their market cap versus Bitcoin was in a constant uptrend. However, their market cap versus Bitcoin this time around has been in a constant downtrend. So since 2018, alts collapsed. They had a massive capitulation. We saw tons of alts get wiped out completely. And we have seen the altcoin market not be as frothy as back then. This alt season hasn't been as large as the previous alt season, at least not in percentage terms, not in USD, not in BTC percentages, okay? Although in USD nominal terms, it has been way more massive, especially if we include derivatives and all the money that has come in and out of the market. We do know that this market has the potential to go much, much higher. And the last thing that I would say is that, for example, the total market cap is looking pretty strong. It has also found some important support at 1.2 trillion in a similar way. And at least this area over here, I don't really know, like, if we come down to this, it could be support. But this, until we broke the level on the 4th of February at about 1.1 trillion as total market cap, and which was around the Tesla news, but before that, alts had started going up massively. So we had the breakout of alts before we had the big Tesla news. So the market had that crazy rally after that, and the market did actually correct this big rally. So we fixed, quote unquote, the Tesla pump. We came back there, we filled the gap, and the market has been in a much healthier trend right now. At least it could be in a much more bullish situation. And to me, for now, the key resistance level is at about 1.9 trillion. I don't know if it's gonna come all the way up there, but so far it's looking pretty healthy, it's looking pretty bullish, and it could go significantly higher. Now, the total market cap looks different. Now, the total altcoin market cap does look a little bit more bearish because this is coming towards some resistance, and the altcoin market cap as a whole doesn't look as healthy. It looks a little bit more bearish than the Bitcoin market cap or the total market cap. But again, maybe it's over, and this has just been a scam pump. However, because the market is looking relatively healthy, I do believe we might go higher. And I do like the fact that across most markets, we did have a sweep of the previous lows, that which came at different times. Some of them came on the 19th of May, some of them came on the 23rd of May. But the best thing is that most alts did correct significantly. The altcoin market cap dropped about 60-70%. And although you cannot really see it on the total market cap, we do know if we go onto individual alts that most of them dropped about 70-80%. And the smaller ones, they got wiped out completely. And remember, not all alts topped at the same time. Some alts topped at the end of February or maybe at the end of January even. Some of them in May, some of them in March, some of them in April. So they topped at different times. So although some of them might look like, although it might look like the total market cap dropped 60%, most of them have dropped a lot more. And the alts that hold them up so far has been Ethereum, Cardano, and some of the major alts that haven't dropped as much as the smaller ones. Okay, so to me, the fact that Bitcoin has held so well, alts have held so well, it gives me hope. Now we are coming towards a resistance area, so a lot will depend on how bad the rejection is. If we go slightly higher from here, if we keep on seeing some strength, I do believe that buying the dips for now would be okay, and I think that taking a long position wouldn't be as bad at the moment, because in my opinion, I don't really know how much more alts and Bitcoin can drop, because we didn't really go up as much. It wasn't like we had that really, really crazy rally, that really crazy market that we need to see that crazy correction afterwards. You know, it's not like this bull market has been so much worse than the previous bull market, because we started from a much better point, from a huge accumulation versus the USD, very slow uptrend, very healthy uptrend. So even if we start dropping, the main issue that I would have is which alts someone would pick rather than actually, you know, the market going much, much lower, because different alts are going to behave differently. So you should be careful of what you are buying. You have to be aware that you need to buy stuff that will hold for quite some time, and they haven't had incredible pumps before that, so you might get trapped. Although the market might continue higher, you don't want to be trapped into alts that don't look good. So that's it from me, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Also remember to follow me on Twitter, TradingView, and Telegram, and I'll see you on the next one. Good luck and bye.